Hey everyone, after I recorded my answering questions video, I got more questions, and there are always questions in the comments that I can answer, so I will combine all of those. And I also had to share some news because I cut my hair again. Like I mentioned, I did meet with a stylist to talk about options that would suit my face, and I did love the shoulder length hair, but I wanted to try something else, like I said, maybe a pixie cut. And she told me that a pixie cut would not be a good idea because I am quite tall and I have a long neck. That would just mean too much neck exposure. That's what she said. And also because I have a lot of hair, it would just be like, poof. Yeah, it wouldn't have been great. So, but then she cut it like this. So she added layers and cut it even a little shorter. And I really love it, so I'm glad I went to see her. Now let's start with the questions from Instagram and on my videos, not in a particular order. The first question is from Maricel Marie. My question is, why do you have a luggage or suitcase by the entrance of your door? Is that a cultural thing? We have it there for decoration, and it contains all our memories, like movie tickets, cards that we got from friends or family, things from our wedding. I found this suitcase at a thrift shop and I really loved it for decoration. And I know a few other people who have luggage or suitcases for decoration. I don't know if it's really a cultural thing. It's not like everyone has it. But I got a lot of questions on it over the last few years. So I'm guessing it's pretty unique, and maybe it is a cultural thing for the Netherlands. I don't know. Because I got so many questions, I'm assuming you guys don't know anyone with a suitcase in the hallway or anywhere in the house for decorations. So maybe it is a cultural thing after all. Then there was a question from Cell Galaxy on how I draw such straight lines in my bullet journal. And I saw other people drawing very straight lines in bullet journals before I started doing it. I just tried it. And it turns out it's not that difficult. You have to practice a little bit. But the trick, I think the main trick, is to lock your wrist. So you don't move your hand or your fingers. You just lock your wrist and then you move your entire arm slowly across the paper. And just stay really focused on the little bullets. Because all you have to do is connect all those little dots. And with a little practice, it's really something that you can easily learn. At least that's my experience. Then there are a few questions from Nicole Larisse. And she says, do you have any hobbies? She has a lot of questions. I'll start with the first one. I do have hobbies. Listening to music, singing, making music. I play violin, flutes and piano. But ever since Victor was born, I think I played the flute once. Played the piano a few times. So for hobbies that I have now, I think YouTube is my main hobby. I really love making videos and everything that comes with YouTube. I really enjoy it so much. And when I don't work on YouTube, I like to read, I like to watch series, I like to work on my bullet journal. And she writes, I see that you have a piano who plays. So I play the piano, but I had only, I think, 3 years of piano lessons. So I'm not the best at playing piano. I am better at playing the flute and violin. I started playing flute when I was 9 and violin when I was 15. And this piano is actually, it's my brother's piano. He lives in a tiny apartment and he doesn't have space for it. He does have a little electronic keyboard. I guess you call it a keyboard, yeah. And my parents have a piano too, so when he wants to play piano, he plays at my parents' house or on his little keyboard. And then she asks, I always wondered what your evening routine is like. Do you have family time or watch TV before bed? How do you wind down from your very busy day? So here's what our evenings usually look like. My husband arrives home after work at 6:30 most of the days. And then I make sure that I have dinner ready. So then we eat together here on the dinner table. And if Victor is really fussy, we take turns eating. Then after dinner, my husband spends time with Victor and I will quickly clean up dinner and sometimes the kitchen, but I mostly clean the kitchen the next day in the morning. And then I edit my videos until about 9:30. And in the meantime, I put Victor to bed. Sometimes I do that. Sometimes my husband puts him to bed. Then he just takes him outside and walks around with Victor in the stroller until he falls asleep. But sometimes I have to nurse Victor to sleep, so I will do that at around 8:30. and then continue editing my videos. And usually I quit editing at 9 or 9:30, and then I will just, well, I have had tea already by then, but I will have another tea, which reminds me, I have tea here, and this is the Teamy Profits tea blend, and I have a discount code for you. So if you are watching on the day that I upload this, on Monday, you can use the code. It's for Cyber Monday, and I will put all the info in the description box. It's a really good deal, so check it out. So 9:30, more tea, and then I will either work on my bullet journal or watch Netflix on the couch or in bed. And at the moment I'm watching One Calls the Heart. It's very much Little House on the Prairie like. And also Crazy Ex-Girlfriend, which is a really weird and crazy series. But that's the fun of it. It is a dark comedy musical, and it is really weird, but I love it. So those two I am watching. I've also watched The Flash and a lot of other series. And then I will go to bed at 10 or 10:30, sometimes a little later, but I try to go to sleep at 10:15 at the latest. Now, of course, sometimes our evening routine is a little different. My husband and I will watch Netflix together. We watch The Good Place together, which is a really funny series. And on Friday, it's date night, so we will go out to dinner, or I will make a special dinner at home, and then we just watch a series or a movie together. And of course, our evening routine isn't always the same. Sometimes I'm very exhausted, and then I won't even do very much editing. I will just crash on the couch and read a book or watch Netflix. But in general, I work on my videos and have lots of tea. Then Naima owner asks, Khadisa is the name of your sister? Yes, Khadisa is the name of my sister. We're not sisters in a way that we share the same parents, but we were a foster home to her. She came to live with us when she was 10, and then she lived with us for the rest of her teenage years. And yeah, we don't share the same parents, but now we are sisters forever. Chrissy Thompson asks, how do you stay motivated and organized? Because I mean, when it comes to the household. Motivated, I really love the results, and I know my husband's, it makes my husband really happy too, so that helps. And it's just really nice and relaxing when your home is nicely organized and clean. So the thought of that keeps me going, I guess, because it's a never-ending story. Laundry and household chores. And when it comes to energy, the main things are getting enough sleep and eating healthy, which for me means not too much dairy and not too much sugar. Sugar is really something, when I have a lot of it, I will get brain fog, also partly because of histamines, I guess, but it's another story. And apart from brain fog, I will also feel really depressed when I have a lot of sugar. I don't know how that works, but that seems to be the case for me. And of course, when I'm depressed, I really don't want to do anything. So I do eat sugar. In fact, I eat a lot of sugar. But I do try to have sugar-free days. And that's one of the reasons I included sugar-free in my habit tracker, because that motivates me to have those sugar-free days. And about histamines, with the help of a great dietitian, I found out that I am histamine intolerant. And when I have a low histamine diet, that helps my health and energy a lot, so that also helps. And yeah, those are the main things when it comes to motivation and energy. Then, with going through the comments, I came across more requests for folding tutorials and ironing tutorials, and those requests will be added to my list for videos to make in the future. And also a lot of requests for the home tour. I don't know when I can film it, but it's on my mind. So my goal is to at least film it in 2017 and not wait until 2018. So I'm sorry if you have to wait a little bit longer, but I am working on it. I will leave it at this. I have some more cleaning to do, and I have to edit this video also, of course. Don't forget to check out the Teamy discount code in the info box. They have great teas and also very cute tea infusers like this one, and also tumblers, and they have detox teas. So a lot of great products. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!